So welcome back everybody to Arch and the Norfolk Broads. It's Sunday, Father's Day, and I thought I'd do a little painting. Not a little painting, it's 30 by 24 I think the canvas is. Yeah, 30 by 24. So what I'm going to do today is, I've been talking about this forever and never got around to it, and I'm going to give it a go today. I'm going to do a bee. Now, a year a bit ago I did a butterfly before I started doing YouTubes, and it went really well and it was okay, but I did it differently than I'm going to do today. I did it more with blown out from the straw, but what I intend to do today is mix it a little bit with the straw and doing some swipes in it, if that makes sense. Now, I know bees are a law unto their own. There's all sorts of bees, different colour bees, different shape bees, honeybees, bumblebees. But what I'm going to do today is my interpretation of how I see a bee. And that's it. I'm going to do the shape, the wings, I'm going to do the colours into it. So instead of using black, I'm going to use violet. Try to anyway. I've got yellow. I've got an orange, which I'll put with the yellow at some point. And then I've got a couple of other colours which I might put into it. Today I'm just going to do the actual bee itself. I have got some plans and some ideas to do bees with flowers and bits and pieces. So I'm just going to go for what I've got today and see how we get on with it and see if it comes out okay. So the base is covered in white, which is two part floral, one part acrylic paint, which is our teaser paints, and one part distilled water. I've mixed that, settled it, left it for a couple of days. And then I've laid it down on the canvas, poured it all off. I've gone across it with the heat gun just to get rid of any bubbles. You can see I've marked off, if you can, in different areas. That's just for me to keep the canvas centered and for me to try and keep the bee. I've measured half the way, put the tapes, and I intend to use that as a center point for the bee. So that's it. I think as it goes along, it'll change a couple of times. Just, I don't know, it's one of these things. I've tried different things, I've got different things in my ideas in my head, but I think it's like everything, until you actually start, it's a difficult one. So I'm just checking the camera. So I've got a couple of designs, a couple of bits and pieces that I've been playing around with, and I think the first part, which I'm really nervous about, is getting the actual body in the center and getting it to the size that I want. It's not like obviously using a pencil or any acrylic paints without the actual base, because once it's down, it's kind of settled. So let's see how we go on. So I've put two dots, which I'm going to come out of for the body. So we'll give that a go. That's okay ish but it's like I say, you know, you can blow it out with the straw, you can change your lines by just pushing it. It's like that. So I wanted to try and get, it's like a peanut really, and if I was to do it the other way, I would do it like that, sort of bee would be coming off, which I will do at some point. So that's what I'm going to do with that. I'm happy with the colour at the top. Just going to create a little top. And then what I'm going to do I'm going to do yellow-ish like this. And I'm going to come down here. Do like a yellow, just like that. That's the plan. Now, I thought a couple of different ways to do this, and I don't know if it's going to work or it's not going to work. I lost my little plastic bits and bobs that I use to actually pull the paint, but I've got another one here. So I'm going to try it like that to start with and do a swipe. Let's see how we get on. That again. but I'm not sure at the moment, but we'll give it a go. So that's as we are at the minute. Now what I'm going to do now is I'm see if we can do something with a straw. I think by losing the straw, what I'm trying to do is get the effect that it's not all shapes, it's you know, the little fur that they have, the interaction with the yellow coming into the purple coming into yellow, but the orange. Because if you look at a bee as it's flying, it's picking up all sorts of light and all sorts of shade. It's not all straight lines, and I think that's what I'm trying to achieve, is a bit of abstract into it. Hopefully. And like I say, with the actual lines, as you're coming down, you draw that initial first line, don't worry about it, because like now, you can try and pull the colours out, so to actually get the actual shape itself. That makes sense. Now, I mean, that's not too bad for a start. I can play around with it a bit to get the shapes to exactly where I want them to be. No pun intended. So that's that. Now for the wings, this is another bit that's going to be a drama, probably. Colour to use. Really thought this through. So I want it to be for the colour. Sort these all out at the end. But obviously you've got to get the legs in as well. So yeah, excuse me playing with my fingers. I'm gonna try it with yellow to start with, I think. Come down about here, I think. Yeah. Of that. What I'm going to do, I think what I'll use here, yeah, a little bit pinks. Yeah.
I'm not particularly sure about this now. And then
Now, that's not bad at the minute. I think it needs another colour of some sort that I can put into it. And I've got, this is sounding really shocking, but I've got this green, and I can hear you all screaming now. But I think it's going to be okay with the colours. Yeah, a bit better. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put it, that's black, just to give it a bit of definition. It's a catering come in there.
Carol, bless her.
I think it's the kind of painting here that you could play around with forever. I want it to be abstract. Anyway, I don't want to bore you too much. Probably bored you enough as it is. But I think you get the idea. I think with this sort of pattern, you can do all sorts with it. I mean, you could put some flowers in it. I know you all think, oh God, he's going to put a flower in it. I'm not. Because I don't think that's the right thing to do. I will play around with this bit here. I'm happy with that. I think that's okay. Maybe I'm putting all the stuff on it. It'll settle down as it comes out. So I think that's just about that, I think. I'm going to leave it for a bit, settle my head, see how I feel. Let Carol have a look at it, see what she thinks. But what I think he's trying to do is give you an idea. So I know acrylic pours, acrylic pour. I know it's, you know, you can do dirty pours, all the bits and pieces, but there's other ways around it. I know some people, it's not their sort of thing. Some it may be, I don't know. Sort this out in a minute, but it gives you an idea, things you can do. Maybe you want to try it yourself, give it a go, see what you think. I'll take the camera down, give you a quick scoot around it, see what you think. I won't bored you, but anyway, I'm not going to play around with it much more. I think that gives you a fair idea. I'll take the camera down and give you a little whiz round and see what you think. So there you go. Anyway, listen, I wish you all well. I hope you're all okay. Take care. Until next time, be safe.